एवरीवन, आई एम असीमा विश्वाल। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ कॉस्ट। फर्स्ट आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट। व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट? द अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट ऑफ एनी गुड इज द नेक्स्ट बेस्ट अल्टरनेटिव गुड दैट इज सैक्रिफाइस्ड। ओके, द फैक्टर्स व्हिच आर यूज्ड फॉर द मैन्युफैक्चर of armaments may also be used for the production of cars or other automobiles. Therefore, the opportunity cost of production of an armament is the output of cars and other automobiles forgot or sacrificed, which could have been produced with the same amount of factors that have gone into the making of an armament. To take another example, a farmer who is producing a wheat can also produce potatoes with the same factors. Therefore, the opportunity cost of a quintal of wheat is the amount of output of potatoes given up. Thus, the opportunity cost of anything is the next best alternative that could be produced instead by the same resources or by of factors having the same monetary value. Two points must be noted in the above definition of opportunity cost. First, the opportunity cost of anything is only the next best alternative for God. That is to say, the opportunity cost of producing a good is not any other alternative good that could be produced with the same factor. It is only the most valuable other good which the same factors could produce. Second point worth noting in the above definition is the addition of the qualification or by an equivalent group of factors costing the same amount of money. Okay, now I will discuss about theory of short-term cost. Okay, before I will discuss about total fixed and variable cost, first I will discuss about what do we mean by short run and long run and variable factors and fixed factors. Okay, there are some inputs or factors which can be readily adjusted with the changes in the output level. Thus, a firm can readily employ more workers if it has to increase output. Likewise, it can secure and use more raw materials, more chemicals without much delay if it has to expand production. Thus, labor, raw materials, chemicals, etc. are the factors which can be readily varied with the change in output. Such factors are called variable factors. On the other hand, where there are factors such as capital equipment, factory building, top management personnel, which cannot be so readily varied, it requires a comparatively long time to make a variation in them. It takes time to expand a factory building or to build a new factory building with large area or capacity. Similarly, it also takes time to order and install new machinery. The factors such as raw materials, labor, etc., which can be readily varied with the change in the output level are known as variable factors. And the factors such as capital equipment, building, which cannot be readily varied and require comparatively long time to make adjustment in them are called fixed factors. Okay, now I will discuss about variable factors and fixed factors. Economists distinguish between the short run and the long run. The short run is a period of time in which output can be increased or decreased by changing only the amount of variable factors such as labor, raw materials, chemicals, etc. In the short run, quantities of the fixed factors such as capital equipment, factory building, etc. cannot be varied for making change in output. Okay. On the other hand, long run is defined as the period of time in which the quantities of all factors may be varied. All factors being variable in the long run, the fixed and variable factors dichotomy holds good only in the short run. In the long run, the output can be increased not only by using more quantities of labor and raw materials, but also by expanding the size of the existing plant or by building a new plant with a larger productive capacity. Now I will discuss about total fixed cost and total variable cost. First I will tell about total fixed cost. Okay. I have already discussed about fixed factors and variable factors, short run and long run. What do we mean by total fixed cost? Total fixed cost are those which are independent of output, that is, they don't change with change in output. Okay, these costs are fixed amount which must be incurred by a firm in the short run, whether the output is small or large. Even if the firm closes down for some time in the short run but remains in business, these costs have been borne by it. Fixed costs are also known as overhead cost and include charges such as contractual rent, insurance fee, maintenance cost, property taxes, interest on the borrowed funds, minimum administrative expenses such as manager's salaries, workmen's wages, etc. Those fixed costs are those which are incurred in hiring the fixed factors of production whose amount cannot be altered in the short run. Now I will tell about total variable cost. Okay. Variable cost, on the other hand, are those costs which are incurred on the employment of variable factors of production whose amount can be altered in the short run. Because the total variable cost changes with change in output in the short run. They increase or decrease when the output rises or falls. These costs include payments to labor employed, the prices of raw materials, fuel, power used, the expenses incurred on transportation and the like. If a firm shuts down for some time in the short run, it will not use the variable factors of production and not therefore include any variable cost. Okay. Variable costs are made only where some amount of output is produced and total variable cost increase with the increase in the level of production. Variable costs are also called prime cost or direct cost. Total cost of a business are the sum total of total fixed cost plus total variable cost. So this figure OX axis represents output, OY axis represents cost. This horizontal line represents total fixed cost. This curve represents total variable cost. Okay. This is total cost. This shows the total fixed cost. Okay. Then this curve shows the total variable cost and this curve shows the total cost. Total cost equal to total fixed cost plus total variable cost. In next class, I will discuss about short run average and marginal cost curves. Thanks for watching.